Hello and welcome to the next video of the series. In this video, we will talk about the discrete implementation of a single lead echocardiogram front-end circuit and discuss how to select op-amps and other components. This slide shows a typical ECG block diagram from the TI website where one can click on each block and get recommended devices. For an ECG circuit, the specific amplifier roles include electrode amplifiers, RLD or right leg drive amplifier, pace detection amplifier, and leadoff detection. While talking about each of these functions, we will also see some recommended devices in the next slides. In any ECG system, there are two types of electrodes, wet and dry. Wet electrodes are electrodes generally made of silver or silver chloride material. They use an electrolyte gel material as a conductor between the skin and the electrode. Input bias current is the current flowing into the inputs of an op-amp. Ideally, the two input bias currents would be equal to each other and would cancel. In reality, though, they are not equal, and the difference of these currents is defined as input offset current. The bias currents are important because they will create a voltage across any input impedance that might exist. If you have a source with high output impedance, you want an amplifier with low input bias current so that you don't introduce a large offset error at the output. Wet electrodes do not have low output impedance, so it is not imperative to have low input bias current on the amplifier. In a wet electrode system, we recommend going with the INA821 for high performance systems. For a more cost-effective or power conservative solution, we recommend the INA826. Next, we will look at what is required for a dry electrode system. Dry electrodes consist of a single metal that acts as a conductor between the skin and the electrode. This material is usually stainless steel. Dry electrodes do have high output impedance, so an amplifier with low input bias current is crucial for maximum accuracy. The proposed solution here is to connect a low IB unity gain buffer to each dry electrode to minimize the error. Voltage error due to input bias current is equal to the input bias current of the amplifier, multiplied by the output impedance of the source, in this case, the dry electrode. The buffer isolates these impedances from the load and the source. The buffer output is low impedance, so the input bias current error of the next stage, the instrumentation amplifier, will be negligible. For a dry electrode system, we recommend the OPA2376 due to its very low bias current of only 10 picoamperes max at room temperature and a very low noise floor of 7.5 nanovolts per root hertz. For a cost-optimized solution, we recommend the TLV376, which offers similar AC performances with slightly higher DC offset. In its basic implementation, a DC voltage could be driven, but the results are improved if the body is driven back dynamically, depending on the interfering common voltage. This is done by constantly monitoring the changing common voltage the two electrodes are riding on top of. This voltage is mirrored around the reference voltage, usually half the supply, and driven back to the body. In summary, as the body is capacitively pulled away from the reference voltage, the RLD circuit pulls it back in. It is traditionally named right leg drive because the driving is done in the right leg. As we have seen in previous videos, one of the challenges associated with biopotential measurements is rejecting the common mode voltages to which the human body, electrodes, and cables are exposed. That is the reason why having an instrumentation amplifier with high CMRR is important. One way of reducing any external common mode interference is by actively driving the body back with a known voltage so that the body is not electrically floating anymore. This voltage is called right leg drive, or RLD. If you're using a fully differential amplifier to measure the output of the electrode, you can use differential outputs to drive the right leg amplifier. The input of the op-amp will be the dynamic common mode voltage of the system referenced around mid-supply. This feedback loop improves CMR by the amount equal to 1 plus A, where A is the closed-loop gain of the feedback loop. The value of the closed-loop gain depends on the values of the feedback impedance and difference amp output common mode sensing resistor. However, this circuit does assume that the common mode voltage at the input of the difference amp is equal to the common mode voltage at the output of the difference amp. If higher accuracy is desired, you can use the input common mode voltage of the difference amp to drive the right leg. An excellent choice for an amplifier in the right leg drive is the OPA3330 drift amplifier. The OPA-333 offers 130 dB CMRR with a flat 1 over F curve at 1.1 microvolts peak-to-peak. For a non-zero drift option, we recommend the OPA-320, which offers a very low noise of 0.8 microvolts peak-to-peak and 90 dB of CMRR. We can also look at the OPA-140, which is a JFET offering a combination of low voltage noise and low current noise, while maintaining high CMRR. It does not assume that the common mode voltage seen at the output is equal to the common mode voltage at the input of the instrumentation amplifier. This circuit utilizes the common mode signal at the input of the amplifier in conjunction with an amp to drive the right leg. Since this application has the same amplifier requirements as the previous application, we recommend the same amplifiers here for the RLD. OPA-333. Cancel 50 to 60 Hz. Generic requirement. OPA-320-145. Cancel higher frequency components. Special requirements with high cap load drive may need lower output impedance. This circuit does not assume that the common mode voltage seen at the output is equal to the common mode voltage at the input of the difference amplifier. This circuit utilizes the common mode signal at the input of the amplifier in conjunction with an amp to drive the right leg. Since this application has the same amplifier requirement, we recommend the same amplifiers here for the RLD. A pace detector is designed to monitor for the presence of a pacemaker signal in an ECG waveform. This detection helps doctors decide how to treat patients. Pacemaker signals appear as high-frequency pulses right before the ECG waveform. The height and width of a pacemaker signal can range anywhere from 2 millivolts to over 500 millivolts in amplitude and 0.1 milliseconds to 500 milliseconds in width, while possibly sharing similar signal characteristics of the ECG pulse. The shape of the signal will differ depending on how the pacemaker is positioned to assist the heart and the type of pacemaker installed. Pace detection can be done either by using dedicated hardware or by using software. The software approach requires the front end to have higher bandwidth and the ADC to have a higher sampling rate. However, one of the advantages of using software pace detection is that as pacemaker devices evolve, the detection thresholds can be dramatically changed via software instead of having to modify the system hardware. The hardware portion of this detection scheme is to amplify the signal from each electrode. That signal is then fed into the difference amplifier. The ADC and processor downstream will analyze this waveform and detect for a pace pulse. This approach needs to be done with care. 0.1 milliseconds is short. Amplifier selection must have the appropriate bandwidth to amplify and capture this. If the pulse width is 0.1 milliseconds and a gain of 10 volts per volt is required, minimum amplifier bandwidth should be at least 1 MHz, or you run into a bandwidth-limited output. For the pace detection system, we recommend the OPA-388 offering 10 MHz of bandwidth and very low noise and offset. For a linear amplifier, we recommend the OPA-2325, which offers 10 MHz of bandwidth. Here is the full circuit showing all of the stages and recommended precision amplifier devices. The general purpose amplifiers from TI offer the most cost-effective and small size amplifiers in the industry. This slide shows recommended devices for cost-optimized ECG applications. For RLD amplifier amplifications, the gain bandwidth requirement is not high, but the amplifier may have to drive a high capacitance load. To meet this requirement and save power here, low-power amplifiers like TLV-904X and 900X could be a good fit. TLV-904X with 1.2 volt minimum supply and low quiescent current not only helps future-proof your design for a small battery voltage, but also saves valuable battery power as well. For leadoff detection, the low input bias current of these devices plays a critical role in making sure the amplifiers used for detection do not add errors. Pacemaker signal is usually a higher frequency and higher amplitude signal in comparison to ECG signal. Hence, a slightly higher offset, high gain bandwidth is deemed acceptable for low-cost signal processing. The TLV-674X that presents 10 MHz gain bandwidth with just 1 millivolt of max offset could be a great fit here. And for even higher bandwidth requirements, one can use OPA-X322 offering 20 MHz gain bandwidth. While the above are supporting functions, Processing the ECG signal requires lower noise, especially in lower frequency, along with lower offset and input bias current. Here's where the OPA-X375 with ultra-low noise 1.2 microvolts peak-to-peak noise in 0.1 to 10 MHz range could fit very well into a cost-optimized signal chain. This slide shows a top-level overview of an ECG signal chain built using GPAMP devices. With a low-power TLV9041, TLV9001 used for our right-leg drive applications. The OPA-2375 with its high gain bandwidth can also be an excellent SAR driver. Pace detection can be done with or without a software algorithm. Note how the pace detection is a pulse with higher amplitude and frequency in comparison to an ECG signal. In the implementation on the left, the signal is high-pass filtered and gained up using TLV-674X and OPA-X322. The gained-up signal is compared to a reference using a window comparator and then latched. In the implementation on the right, the signal just gained up using TLV-674X and OPA-X322 and is fed into the ADC. The detection of the pace signal is done in a digital domain using an algorithm. This concludes our signal conditioning circuits for single-lead ECG using discrete op-amps. For more information, visit ti.com/medical. Thanks for watching.